Hello. In this session, we will be focusing on the theory of existentialism and how it applies to art. We are aware that most of the pre-20th century philosophers were concerned with the abstract questions of idea, form, reason, and so on. Most of these theoreticians failed to recognize the immediate condition in which the human being is placed. The anxiety, boredom, and alienation one feels in real life was surprisingly neglected by earlier philosophers. It is the existentialists who gave focus to these realities of human existence. Existentialism as a philosophical and literary movement came into prominence during the period adjacent to Second World War. But existentialist ideas can be seen in the work of many earlier philosophers. Soren Kierkegaard and Friedrich Nietzsche are considered to be the pioneers of existentialist thought. Soren Kierkegaard offered metaphysical solution to the problem of being, but Nietzsche followed a nihilistic approach. Husserl and Heidegger are also considered to be existentialists in their approach. Existentialism was not only a philosophical movement. Many of the thinkers expressed their ideas through their literary works too. So, the key figures of existentialist thought also include well-known literary figures like Dostoevsky. Many existentialists refused themselves to be called as existentialists. The key figures of the movement are Sartre, Simone de Beauvoir, Camus, Marcel, Merleau-Ponty, so on. Existentialism, like Dadaism, can also be thought of as a movement born out of angst of post-war Europe. Men felt abandoned in an absurd world. The faith in social systems were lost, and this in turn led to the theory of the freedom of the individual. To an existentialist, existence is more important than essence. The being feels that he is in a world where others exist. The conscious being feels self and that which is not the self, the other. Most of the time, the world appears to be hostile. The being can choose the way in which he interacts with this world. It is this choice of will which defines the freedom of an individual. The series of conscious decisions or choice defines the destiny of an individual. Thus, the existentialists believe that an individual wills his own destiny. For existentialism, human freedom grounds the very possibility of knowledge in its deepest form, that is, the capacity of human beings to reveal something about reality. The freedom of will thus gives the possibility to humans to search for knowledge in its deepest form. He can search for the reality of his own existence. Then there arises a question of the creation of the self and the other. This question was answered by existentialist thinkers in two different ways. One way accepts the existence of God and the other way denies it. Gabriel Marshall and Buber belong to the first group of Christian existentialists. Gabriel Marshall defines human freedom in metaphysical terms as the capability of the human mind to make itself available to the will of the Creator, the Great Other. Atheistic existentialist thinkers like Camus, Sartre, Simone de Beauvoir, Merleau-Ponty, and others do not accept faith in God to be an answer to the condition of human freedom. To them, a definite objective answer to this problem may not be possible within the current human capacity. One can only search for an objective meaning inside a world which offers absurd conditions of existence. And a search for order brings them into direct conflict with the universe. But reality offers freedom of the will with which an individual can determine his choices and action. The only positive feature of human reality is the feeling of responsibility towards oneself and others. Only a man of real freedom can take on this in a proper, responsible manner. Others will deny themselves the search for existential answers by playing predefined roles throughout their life. Sartre named such a human as somebody with bad faith. Marshall defines such a person as functional man. When the self exists in the world, it goes through many conditions. One such condition is the state of dread. Dread needs the existence of other objects in the world. There is another somewhat similar state, anxiety. For anxiety, an interaction with the other is not needed. It is a self-induced state. Anxiety comes out of our understanding of the total freedom of choice that confronts us every living moment. An individual has to decide his actions every moment, and this shapes his future. Anxiety also comes forth from the individual's confrontation with nothingness. Sartre states, nothingness is our inherent lack of self. We are in constant pursuit of a self. Nothingness is the creative wellspring from which all human possibilities can be realized. Our awareness of death can bring us freedom or anguish. Existentialist philosophers use the Danish term angst rather than anxiety to define the condition of insecurity and despair. Look at the painting presented here. This is a painting done by Edvard Munch, the great Norwegian modern master. For an existentialist, the being and the world are not static but dynamic. Every being is in a state of becoming, in a state of continuous change. The constant flux and momentum of everyday existence, the feeling of pain, dread and angst find expression through this masterwork. Sartre says that every imaginary presentation of the world is an act of a freedom speaking to other freedoms about possible ways of engaging freedom in the world. In this sense, the above painting is also a statement about human freedom. To an existentialist, meaning is generated continuously by the being in its interaction with the other. What an artist does is to impose a structure, a possibility of meaning to a chaotic world and present it within the framework of specificity. A choice of freedom taken by the artist reveals a fundamental existential attitude towards the world, and this attitude finds its expression in the work of art. But it is to be stressed that the manifestation of subjective expression found in a work of art is not that which is essentially important, but the statement of freedom embedded within it. Thus, artistic practice is linked to ethical and political choices. The danger here is that the artist can have a bad faith and base his choice upon it. The stress on decisive subjective choice makes an existentialist work different from an artwork of romanticism. Freedom and self-determination are active notions for the existentialist, while in a romantic work, nature take over the self-determination of the artist. But existential writer Camus, in his book The Outsider, creates instances where to liberate oneself from the illusion of meaning, one abandons the self in communion with nature or indulge in eroticism. This may also be taken as a hedonistic escape from freedom due to bad faith. It is the intention of the artist which creates meaning. Imagination is a specific type of intentional activity. The capacity of imagination can be seen as a very